Good morning students. Today's online class we have seen the best practices related to online safety. Now what are the online safety that we have to follow? First is related to your system. Number one, use antivirus. Antivirus is a program that protects your system against virus attack. Now while using internet, our computer system might be get affected by virus. For that matter, we need to install programs of software, that is antivirus software, antivirus program. Those are example are McAfee, AVG, Quick Heal and Symantec. Second one is keep backup your data. Now suppose there is every danger of a virus attack, it is always wise and advisable to keep your data in another or secondary storage device. Third, always scan attachments. While you use internet, while getting messages, there is always a threat, always the possibility of virus being attacked. Therefore, when you open your messages sent through attachment, please scan it. Email is the most common means of transferring virus, trojan, malware, etc. to your system. Please underline that. Think before clicking. Now while browsing net or surfing internet, unnecessarily in a hurry or at random, do not click on everything and anything. Be careful or be vigilant while clicking on the web pages. Second one is protecting yourself as a person, as a user. Here, choose strong passwords. This is very important. Password is a safe way to prove your identity. It's a password is a secret and confidential address or number or symbols that is made. It should be a strong, unique password. Please underline, choose a strong and unique password. Now your password should contain a combination of letters, numbers and symbols. Please underline that also. Password should contain a combination of letters, numbers and symbols. Next is do not give your personal details to strangers. Do not make mistake in giving out your details. They will misuse you and they will harass you, they will cheat you. Next is be careful when making friends. You have to be very, very careful. Sometimes they are not genuine, they are not true, they are not good. They will mislead you. So choose your friends carefully. Underline that. Choose your friends carefully while you through internet. Last one is practice caution. You have to be very, very careful. Extra care you need to take when shopping online, because always check the validity of the website. The website of online are not always true and genuine. They are not real. Sometimes they are fake. They will make you to pay the money, but they will not send you the articles or things or goods that you have ordered. Be extra careful when sharing your card details or making payment bill. Next is how you will become a responsible digital citizen. Responsible, a good digital citizen. A digital citizen is a person who uses internet safely and in the right way. Please underline that. A digital citizen is a person who uses internet safely and in the right way. Now first one is observe etiquette, or when online you have to follow code of conduct. Yes, always you have to be very polite. Do not use harsh words. Second point is report unlawful activities. If someone is harassing you, disturbing you, or threatening you, or illegal activity on the internet, always you inform your parents, your elders, or teachers. Next, do not tamper with others' files or folders. Do not open or delete or use or copy others' files and folders. 4. Never create fake identity. Do not create a false identity. Always keep your identity real. 5. Do not copy information as it is from the internet. Always you read, go through the matter and choose the applicable or related matters for your use. Do not copy as it is. So we have studied today what are the best practices related to online safety, means how you will follow online safety related to your system, that is your computer, and related to yourself as user. We also learned about responsibility of a good digital citizen. What are the etiquettes you have to follow, code of conduct that you have to follow. So these are all about today's online lesson. Please go through the recap also and the lessons carefully and learn the study materials that is sent to you.